Reinforced concrete is typically comprised of concrete and steel reinforcement. The reasoning behind to combine concrete and steel is because both the materials complement each other. It will become clearer when we look at some of the material properties. Here we have concrete and we have reinforcement. In terms of compressive strength, concrete is good in compression, so the compressive strength of concrete is high. When you look at steel reinforcement, compressive strength is good. However, slender elements buckle under compression. Good. Concrete is not good in tension. Concrete, in fact, has very little tensile capacity. And steel is good in tension. When it comes to shear strength, concrete has a fair amount of shear strength. And steel is good in terms of shear strength. In terms of durability, concrete is good and steel tends to corrode if not protected. When it comes to fire resistance, concrete is good and steel is poor against high temperatures. If you just take concrete or just steel, then they have different properties. However, as I mentioned before, these properties complement each other when put together. Combined product acquires following properties. From concrete, good compressive strength with some shear strength and ability to protect embedded steel, reinforcement from corrosion and fire because concrete is durable and it is good against fire. And reinforced concrete acquires properties from steel such as good tensile strength and good shear strength. When designing reinforced concrete elements, it is widely accepted to completely ignore the tensile capacity of concrete due to the fact that the tensile strength of concrete is very small. Hence, the design needs to be undertaken so that the steel reinforcement is carrying the tensile forces. However, these tensile forces need to be transferred from concrete to steel. This transaction of tensile forces is achieved by having good bond condition between steel and concrete. Otherwise, steel will slip within the concrete. It is common practice to assume perfect bond conditions between steel and concrete. Hence, it is important to detail the steel reinforcement correctly to achieve perfect bond conditions. As an example, providing adequate spacing between steel bars to achieve proper concrete compaction. And also providing adequate lap length to have sufficient mechanical grip from the ribs in the bars. As you can see here, there are these ribs in the rebars and you need to provide adequate lapping length so they provide adequate mechanical grip. Having perfect bond conditions, it is assumed that the strain in the reinforcement steel is the same as the strain in the surrounding concrete. As you can see, this is the rebar and this is the surrounding concrete. Having perfect bond conditions, it is assumed that the strain in the reinforcement steel is same as the strain in surrounding concrete, and this is called compatibility of strains. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any questions, please post your questions in the comment section below. If you like the video, please like the video. And if you would like to see more videos like this one, please subscribe to our channel. If you have any suggestions for future videos or if you have any questions that you would like us to cover in a video, please let us know.